Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to part 13 of HTML tutorial series, and in this lecture we will study HTML image maps and HTML iframes. In the previous lecture we had some issues in image maps, and today we will clear those issues. And image map tag is used to define an image map, and it is basically the image with the clickable areas. We have a whole image, and in that whole image, wherever we click, we will get the zoomed image of that area, and the image defined in that area or in that coordinates would be visible to us. So for this purpose, we will see the practical example so that it would be more clear that what are image maps. I'm going to open my Brackets software, that is my text editor, and I will open a new file new, and I'm going to save this file with the name of map.html on my desktop. Okay, and here I would have my starting tag of HTML and ending tag, and I would have body tag. Inside body tag, I would firstly write the image tag, and in image tag I would have the source named as planets, the name of the image planets.gif. It is saved on my desktop with this name, and I have a width suppose of 200 pixels, and I have the height equals, it has the value of 200, and then alternatively I would use the image named as sun. Okay, and here I would have a new attribute of the image tag, that is use map equals, its value would be declared later. Here image tag is closed, and here we are having our map tag, map map tag, and inside map tag I would declare the areas of the images that I want to see as zoomed images. I would declare the area tag would have the name attribute, and you must keep in mind that the area tag's name attribute value would be same as the image tags use map value. These two values must be same. Here you would write the name, suppose planets map. So in the use map you would write this value as hash planets map. Okay, so this thing you should take care of. Then you have the chords attribute, and inside chords attribute you would declare the chords, and there are four chords basically. Just a second, I would make it more clear to you. Okay, I have different chords, and the chords have four values for a rectangle, and the four values would be x1 y1 and x2 y2. And I also have the shape attribute. Firstly, I would declare over here. The shape attribute would have the values called rect or circle, or it may be a polygon. For this, we will use the value as poly. And coordinates, we have, in coordinates, we have 0, 0, 82. And 126, and as an alternative image I would like to use sun. Suppose in the above image I would change it as planets. Okay, this doesn't matter as such a lot sun. Okay, and in href attribute I would have the name of my image that is placed on my desktop that I want to see as zoomed, sun.jpg. Okay, here we are closing our area tag, right? So in this way we will write the area tag inside the map tag, having shape, name, quads, alt and href as attributes. We are going to copy this and control V, enter, control V. Okay, the name attribute must be present inside the map tag. Cut, it should be present over here. Control V. Right, so this must be very clear to you that map tag name value and this use map value should be same. Okay, and area tag would have these shape, coordinates, alt and href as attributes. I will use over here the next image I want to show other than sun would be Mercury. It would be named as Mercure and is placed on my desktop, and the third image I would to show would be Venus, that is also placed on my desktop, and alternatively I would like to show as Venus when Venus, and alternatively I want to show here as Mercury. Okay, and you must be careful about the attributes that should be used. The attributes must not be repeated inside, and for this I would like to set my attributes as suppose 100 and 00, 110 and 200. Okay, and third image I want to set my attributes as 00 and 150 would be present over here, and the shape would be circle. Okay, the shape would be circle, and the circle would have three circle chords would have three values, and shape chords, rectangle chords would have four values inside it. So in this way we will use the area tag for showing images inside our whole main image, that is planets.gif. Okay, I'm going to see what would happen in my browser. Its name is map, map map. Okay, here I would like to open it with Google Chrome. Okay, here we are having our image, and with the hand tool you will click the image and you will see that zoomed image, that is sun. And if you click in any of the area that is closer to the defined coordinates, then you will see the sun again. Yes, okay. And now if I get out of this coordinates of the sun image, I would see the image of Venus. Similarly, I like to see Mercury. In this area I have defined Mercury, so I am getting the image of Mercury. So in this way, from the whole image you will click inside it and you will get the zoomed images. This is with the help of map tag. Okay, now I am going to tell you about other HTML tag, that is the main tag of today's lecture, and that is HTML iframes. And iframe is used to display a web page within a web page, and iframe syntax would be iframe source equals URL value. URL would be used as a source value over here, and iframe tag would be closed. Right, the source attribute specifies the URL of the inline frame page, and iframes height and width would be set with the help of height and width attributes, and I would see the practical example for this purpose. File, new, control S, II. I'm saving this file with the name of II. I recommend that you must write some logical name for your files. I have placed this image, this document on my desktop. HTML starting tag, HTML closing tag is over here, and I'm using body tag over here, and inside my body tag I'm going to use iframe tag is starting over here and closing over here, and inside iframe tag I would have source equals source would have the values like http www.level3schools.com. okay, you have this website over here written in this way inside the source of the iframe tag. And iframe, actually this whole is the web page. Iframe would be some area of that web page, and inside that area you would see this website inside that particular area defined by iframe. Okay, now control S, see what happens inside our HTML document placed on our desktop. I would like to open it with Google Chrome, and here I am getting what I wanted. I have made the iframe, and inside iframe I am getting this website. Okay, so in this way you can use iframe tag, and you can also use iframe tag along with the anchor tag, so that if you click on that link defined by the anchor tag, you will go to that image, that iframe tag, that iframe tag value, actually source attribute value, actually you will go to that with the help of that anchor tag link. Okay, so I'm going to define my anchor tag over here. Firstly, for this example, I have to show you that. Okay, this is after target for a link. Okay, this is the topic named as iframe target for a link. We will cover it later. So for now, I will tell you about that, how you remove the borders of the iframe and change the color and the border style of the iframe. For this, we will use CSS, and in order to remove the border, I will use style property border none, and in order to change the color, I will use the border property. Okay, here I would declare the style property style equal to border colon none. Border would be none, right? So in this way I would not see the border inside my I image. See, here we are having border. So what if I reload my page? I do not have any sort of border inside the iframe tag. So you can make it a border free iframe like this. And if you want to change the color of the border or change the width of the border of the iframe, you would do it as style equals quotes border colon, you are having then the thickness of this border, then you would have the style of this border, that is solid, then you would have the color of the border. Suppose I want to use green as a color for my border of the iframe, I would save it and would like to see it as must show the color of the border. I have some issues. Yes, we must not use semicolon over here, right? This is the syntax for the border: border thickness, border style, and border color. Control S. Okay, this is the right syntax. Now see what happens inside. Yes, I am having the border of green color having the width of 2 pixels. So in this way we can set some CSS properties for iframe tag. Then the thing I was telling you, that we can also have the anchor tag inside our iframe iframe tag, and that anchor tag would have a link. If we click on that link, we would go to that iframe. We would reach to that iframe inside our web page. We would see the example for this purpose. Suppose in the same page I am doing, I am having my example of iframe with the anchor tag. Suppose I am having the iframe with the height of equals 300 pixels. Then I would have the width of 100%. Okay, then I would have the source of this iframe tag as the same source I would copy from the above. Copy, control V. Okay, then I would have the name attribute of the iframe. The name attribute of the iframe would be, suppose, iframe underscore A. Right, then this iframe tag would be, no, it must not be closed over here. It must be, yes, it is closed over here. Then inside this iframe tag, I should remove this so that it becomes clear to you that what if we are having anchor tag inside iframe tag, and inside this iframe tag I would have the anchor tag as a href equals http colon www.w3schools.com closed. Then I have a target equals, okay, inside target I would be having my value that would be same as the name attribute value of the iframe tag, right? I would have iframe underscore A over here, control V, right? And this anchor tag is closed over here. And inside the text of the anchor tag, I would write as link. Link to site. Okay, so in this way, we would write our link and click on that link, and we would go to that iframe, right? This thing must be kept in mind that the target value of the anchor tag must be same as the name attribute value of the iframe tag. Control S. And here we are having our II. Yes, this is the thing. Actually, the size is larger. It must show as a link to the site. Link to the site must be shown over here. Control S. Reload. Okay, suppose what if I remove this source from here, from iframe tag. It is only having three attributes at this time: height, width, and name. Control S. Okay. What if I change the width? Its width as, suppose, not 100%, 50%, and height is 300 pixels. Okay, so now see what happens. Can we? No, we are not going to see our anchor tags. Control S. It must show the link inside the anchor tag. That's not visible at this time. Okay. would try to see that before this I have. Here we are having our iframe tag, and along with iframe tag I am using my anchor tag. You must keep this thing in your mind that iframe tag is declared once, and like this iframe tag is starting over here and it is ending over here in the same line. And after iframe tag you will use the anchor tag. You will not use anchor tag inside iframe tag. So let's see what happens inside our browser. I'm going to reload it. Yes, this is going to happen in my browser. I am seeing this link due to the anchor tag. When I click on this link, I would see something inside my iframe, the website inside my iframe that is declared inside the anchor tag in this way, like, okay. So if we want to increase the width, for example, I would use 100% over here, and height as 200 pixels, for example. Control S, reload, and when I click to this link, I would see it as this, okay. So in this way, I am going to see this website inside my iframe when I click on this link, okay. So we will work like this. Iframe with anchor tag, then I am having onwards. Okay, that's all for today's lecture, iframes. And we have studied iframes target for a link, iframes general properties with CSS, then iframe width and height, and the general syntax of iframe. And before this, we have studied HTML maps. Thanks for watching this lecture, and kindly subscribe the channel. Allah Hafiz.